Hello, Epic Fails. I am Bobby Black from the N-Squared Circle on Wrath and Revolution, bringing you the true face of pro wrestling and this week's SmackDown review. But first, you've got to see something epic. That was my face to heel turn. First off, over this past week, a lot has happened. I've stepped out from the norm. Everyone's praising the Rock for his Survivor Series match. Bull crap. Alright? First off, I'm not a fan of The Rock. Everyone knows it. Might as well not deny it. I really don't want The Rock to win at WrestleMania. I'm not a fan of John Cena whatsoever, but I'm even less a fan of The Rock. And that's why I've started my enemy of my enemy movement, where John Cena is my enemy, of my enemy, which is The Rock, is my friend, which is John Cena. So for right now, I support John Cena to win at WrestleMania 28. Now, I don't care what the rest of you think out there, because y'all are a bunch of hypocritical tapeworms, if I can steal a Jericho phrase, because... you know, all of you guys are praising, you guys want, you know, The Rock to come back from the Attitude Era, and oh, the wrestling's gonna get good again, and blah, 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 bull crap. Okay, The Rock's gonna come back, he's gonna say the same stupid crap. Team, bring it, via satellite. All we're ever gonna get is a bunch of vignettes from The Rock. Yeah, he's back part-time. He's not even back part-time, he's back as a celebrity. Sorry, I think Floyd Money Mayweather made more appearances so far than The Rock has in the past year. Just saying. So anyway, I would like to thank my new subscribers, which is Ginger Greek and SRZMan1. I would also like to thank everyone who left comments on my videos. Erlen D9393, Class of 1333, DW Squirtle, The John WWE, King Tim UK, Zamario WTF PUGJ, and The Jericho 1123, aka Christ the Philemon, or however you say your name. Alright, a little bit of news. Zamario Wrestles channel has been hacked. So everyone needs to, if you have not subscribed to The Zamario, I am going to put a link in the description box. You need to subscribe to his original channel, and that's where all of his wrestling vids are going to be based out of now, is just from there. Secondly, I already started talking about the Enemy of My Enemy petition on Twitter. I have a petition, it's called Enemy of My Enemy. If you sign up and follow me on Twitter, you'll be able to see the petition. I'll put a link in the description box. Go on there, sign it. Basically, all it's saying is that you would rather see Cena win than The Rock at WrestleMania. I know I'm very, very few people, but there's enough of us that if we get enough people to sign this petition, WWE might listen. I mean, shoot, if Zack Ryder can get a dumb petition for having, you know, to have Zack Ryder get a U.S. title shot, then we can do this for Cena. As I said, I'm not a Cena fan. I don't like Cena at all. But I like The Rock even less at this point. You know, so... anyway. And then just a quick announcement about next week. Next week's SmackDown will be on Tuesday night. It will be live. So that means I will have my live review on Top Rope TV on WrestlingRevolution.com, the Epic Center for all your wrestling needs. Go there. You can sign up and register. And we've got forums and contests and all this other great BS that you guys probably won't click the link, but... if you do, you won't regret it. And if you don't, then you're dumb. Sorry. Alright, let's jump into SmackDown. Get ready for the SmackDown! Get ready for the SmackDown! Hey, you're gonna react when you're putting your back now. Cause there's no turning back. This week's SmackDown is in Wilkes Barre, PA, and I probably mispronounced that, but I don't care. It's probably some hick town anyway. We start off with an in-ring promo where Mark Henry limps out with a crutch, with a foot and ankle boot on, basically selling the injury from Survivor Series. And he says that he's an example to kids. What kind of person does this to somebody? Of course, they're kind of playing off like the cheap heat about, you know, Mark Henry being a hypocrite, which is kind of dumb. I really don't like the angle they went on this with. The Big Show comes out and calls Mark Henry on his BS and just basically says that Mark Henry had the low, you know, he didn't hit him, Big Show, in the knee. He hit him in the groin for the purposeful DQ.
So then Mark...
Mark says that the Big Show is the world's biggest loser. Then Big Show knocks out Mark Henry. Big Show leaves. Daniel Bryan comes in, cashes in Money in the Bank, pins Mark Henry, becoming the new World Heavyweight Champion. And the crowd went crazy. Until Teddy Long came out. And Teddy Long screwed everything up. And he reversed the decision because he said Mark Henry was not in any physical condition to compete, which doesn't make any sense because you can, you should be able to cash in Money in the Bank whenever. I mean, look, I mean, everybody is cashing Money in the Bank on, except for Rob Van Dam. Everybody's cashing the Money in the Bank at the at an opportune time. Even CM Punk, Jack Swagger, Edge. And the only one who cashed in ahead of time was Rob Van Dam. So, which I kind of wish Daniel Bryan would do, but at the same time, I was marking out when Daniel Bryan won it. But I kind of knew it was a little not long for this world anyway. So anyway, Teddy Long comes out, he says that Mark Henry wasn't able to compete, so henceforth, this match never happened.
Mark Henry... See?
You guys bore me. Teddy Long gives the world title back to Mark Henry, and Daniel Bryan gets his briefcase back. But Teddy Long makes a main event tonight, which is a number one contendership fatal four-way match with Randy Orton, Cody Rhodes, Wade Barrett, and Daniel Bryan. We're going to the first match of the night, which is Justin Gabriel versus Hunico. I gave this 3 out of 5 Black Rangers. It was an okay match, but it just seems like they're turning Hunico into like the Conan from WCW 2.0. It just, I don't know. They're just doing the whole, you know, gangsta Latino thing. I'm just waiting for him to do like a rolling clothesline or something like that. So it was an okay match to kick off like the first match of the night. It wasn't bad. I wish they would have given Justin Gabriel the win, honestly. I thought he needed the win more than Hunico, but we'll see how. I just hope they don't release Justin Gabriel. I think he's a great talent. I think he should honestly feud with Cody Rhodes for the IC title. I think that would be the next step for Justin Gabriel. Second match of the night, which is Beth Phoenix and Natalia versus the Anvilette versus AJ and Caitlyn. This is a rematch from last week. Alicia Fox was on commentary. I gave this 1 out of 5 Pink Rangers. This match sucked. This match was a shadow of what last week's match was. Last week's match was decent, like 4 out of 5, I'm pretty sure. This match was 1 out of 5. It sucked. I mean, it was a squash match, and Caitlyn didn't help her partner at all. AJ tapped out of the sharpshooter again. Afterward, it was called what Beth was calling cry time, which Beth Phoenix Natalia puts a sharpshooter back on AJ and makes her cry and cry, and Caitlyn just walks out. Alicia Fox actually gets up from the commentary table and actually steps up and tries to go up against Beth Phoenix and Natty, and, you know, Beth Phoenix and Natty are just like, oh, here you go. So, anyway, next, we go to a backstage segment where Teddy Long is talking to Oksana. I don't even remember what they were talking about, nor did I care. Mark Henry comes in, and he complains about what happened earlier in the night and how he can put him in a match next week on SmackDown. Teddy Long informs him that, yeah, well, next week's SmackDown match, world title match, it's going to be in a steel cage. So, next, we have another backstage segment with Sheamus and Zack Ryder. Nobody, I mean, it was just like Zack Ryder singing and Sheamus acting like he was angry. I don't know. It's kind of dumb, actually. Third match of the night, American Perfection, which is a tag team of Dolph Ziggler and Jack Swagger, versus Zack Ryder and Sheamus. I gave this 4 out of 5 Red Rangers. This was a really good tag team match, mostly because American Perfection worked really well together. Zack Ryder and Sheamus were okay, but mostly Swagger and Ziggler carried this match. So this was a pretty good match. These guys did a really good job at working together. I kind of wish that, I mean, it was a clean finish. I just kind of wish, you know, that the American Perfection would have went over instead of Zack Ryder and Sheamus. I know, but it just seems better to plug one of your official tag teams than one of your thrown-together tag teams. In the end, Zack Ryder makes a blind tag onto Sheamus, and then Zack Ryder comes in and capitalizes. Dolph Ziggler tries to go for a zigzag on Sheamus. He misses, and then Zack Ryder hits the Rough Rider for the win. Next, we have a backstage segment with Daniel Bryan and AJ. Daniel Bryan is complaining about what happened earlier in the night about Teddy Long reneging on his world title. Barrett comes in and they exchange words back and forth, and Daniel Bryan says he's not going to be intimidated by Barrett, Orton, or Mark Henry, or whoever. Bryan stands his ground, and AJ kisses him on the cheek and wishes him luck. Good luck, Danny. Or
Bryan.
Ooh, Bryan. Anyway, fourth match of the night, which is Teddy Biasi versus Heath Slater. It was kind of an undercard match. It was a good undercard match, so these two went back and forth. I gave it 3 out of 5 Yellow Rangers. These two guys really showed me a little bit here. Slater still can wrestle, I think. I mean, yeah, he's annoying, but he can wrestle, in my opinion. Teddy Biasi, also another great talent who can wrestle. Worth noting that in the beginning of this match, as soon as the bell rang, Jinder Mahal comes on the Titantron and basically blasts DiBiase from walking away from all the money that he inherited, or he would inherit, and all this other garbage to hang out with commoners. Basically making reference to the DiBiase posse out in the parking lots before, you know, events. Eh. So they're starting Jinder Mahal to DiBiase storyline. Slater controls most of the beginning of this match, but in the end, DiBiase hits a Dream Street for the win, so to DiBiase and the DiBiase posse roll forward. Alright, next up we have a backstage segment with Cody Rhodes. Basically just, he says that he's free without the mask, and then he makes fun of Booker T. So can you dig that? Fifth match tonight, main event, Daniel Bryan versus Randy Orton versus Cody Rhodes versus Wade Barrett. 5 out of 5 Green Rangers. Epic match. I bet you can guess what the Mon Mon's going to be this week. This Fatal 4-Way was awesome. Not only was it got way a really good time, it was really well put together. 4 great wrestlers were in this match. And it's just, I mean, you know, I'll let the Mon Mon explain the rest, but this was an awesome match. In the end, Cody Rhodes goes to pin Daniel Bryan, but Daniel Bryan reverses it into a LaBelle lock, and Cody Rhodes taps out. After the match, Cody Rhodes starts to beat down on Daniel Bryan until Randy Orton makes a save and RKO's Cody Rhodes. The night ends with Daniel Bryan standing tall. So next week on the live edition of Tuesday Night SmackDown, we're going to have Daniel Bryan versus Mark Henry in a steel cage. What I give the night as a whole? I gave it a very high 3 out of 5 Blue Rangers. I would have been at 2, but the thing that saved it was the main event was very good. I was kind of disappointed with the Daniel Bryan angle that they did in the beginning. They made up for it with the main event, but it wasn't enough to, you know, make this night incredibly worth it. There were kind of a couple throwaway matches, but, I mean, between American Protection versus... American Perfection versus Zack Ryder and Sheamus and... Fatal 4-Way main event, I think that this night pretty much redeemed itself. So, now we move on to Booker T's quote of the night, which is...
I'm trying to figure out what's going on in court. Why are these guys working together? I mean, don't they know what this is all about? This is for a title shot.
Booker, if you would be quiet, I'd answer your question. Bryan's out of the equation right now. If you can injure Orton and take him out of the equation, now you're down to a one-on-one match, and it's 50% chance for each of these guys.
What's this? You know what, Cole? That makes no sense at all. That's what that is. I mean, come on. These
what
guys...
are you talking about?
Oh, so you say get rid of Randy so we can fight one-on-one, right? Yeah. Now, come on. That's stupid.
Yeah, that hot mess. I had to play the whole, like, minute clip because Booker T just doesn't make any sense. He's talking about being in a Fatal 4-Way and teaming up with somebody in that Fatal 4-Way to eliminate the other people. Then it would be down to them to go one-on-one. I mean, like, Michael Cole makes perfect sense, and Booker T's just not. I mean, Booker T's an idiot. I mean, that's what they portray him as in this whole thing, so... I don't get what in the world they're trying to do with Booker here, but he sounds like an idiot. And next up, the match of the night montage, which goes to, of course, the Fatal 4-Way main event, which was epic. This is the longest Mon I've ever done in its short span so far, so don't click off, but enjoy.
My own affliction. I am my own disease. There ain't no drug that could sell. No, there ain't no drug to make me well. There ain't no drug. There ain't no drug.
I made a mess of me. I wanna give back the rest of me. I made
our souls in cages. We hide inside our shells. It's hard to free the ones you love. Oh, and you can't forgive yourself. Yeah, forgive yourself. Ain't no drug.
Alright everyone, that wraps it up for this week's SmackDown. Don't forget, next Tuesday night on Top Rope TV, I'm going to have my live review of SmackDown, just like they have their live showing of SmackDown. We're going to hopefully see Daniel Bryan win the World Heavyweight Championship. I doubt it, but we'll see. I'm Bobby Black from the Unsquared Circle and WrestlingRevolution.com. Please comment, like, subscribe. Hashtag Mark.